No, living thoughtfully and generously towards others to ensure they feel welcome. Welcome to today's DDRX. The prescription is say a blessing, Psalm 107 verse 2. So we're looking at overflowing blessings and our responsibilities. David wrote in Psalm 23 verse 5, "You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, my cup runs over." Today, we want to look at hospitality, sharing of home and food, meeting another's need for food and shelter. In Hebrews 13 verse 2, "Do not forget to entertain strangers, for by so doing, some have unwittingly entertained angels." In Greek, hospitality is a word called philoxenia, which means love of strangers, philoxenia. No, living thoughtfully and generously towards others to ensure they feel welcome, included, and loved. In 1 Peter 4, 9-10, "Be hospitable to one another without grumbling. As each one has received a gift, minister it to one another as good stewards of the manifold grace of God." In 2 Kings 4, 8-10, now this is a narrative of, now it happened one day that Elisha went to Shunem, where there was a notable woman, and she persuaded him to eat some food. So it was, as often as he passed by, he would turn in there to eat some food. And she said to her, "Look now, I know that this is a holy man of God who passes by us regularly. Please let us make a small upper room on the wall, and let us put a bed for him there, and a table, and a chair, and a lampstand. So it will be whenever it comes to us, he can turn it in there." That rich woman was highly hospitable. You know what happened in 2 Kings 4, 14 to 17? The Lord met her need. The Lord provided a son to this woman. You know, we also read in 1 Samuel chapter 30, this was at a time the Amalekites invaded David's camp when he was away. And they took his wives, they took his possession. David was discouraged. The people even wanted to stone him. In 1 Samuel, chapter 30, David consulted God. God said, "Pursue, overtake." God had given him the blessings, but he needed, to be wise. In 1 Samuel 30, 11 to 12, when they were pursuing according to the instruction of God, then they found an Egyptian in the field and brought him to David. And they gave him bread, and he ate, and they let him drink water. And they gave him a piece of a cake of figs and 2 clusters of raisins. So when he had eaten, his strength came back to him, for he had eaten no bread nor drunk water for 3 days and 3 nights. This was the man God used to give intelligence. And that was how they were able to win the war. They were able to experience restoration, blessings. They were able to pursue. They were able to overtake. They were able to get back all their belongings. You too can say blessings. According to Genesis 18, 17, "And the Lord said, shall I hide from Abraham what I'm doing?" And this was after Abraham had entertained angels. Even as you open up your womb, your house to strangers, say it. I begin to enjoy divine secrets, divine revelation, and overflowing blessings.